In this video, I'll demonstrate how to create an assembly that has a component span. In a previous tutorial, I showed some examples of spans comprised of components. One example is Railing Assembly 14, whose span named Inner is a component. I can find this component in the In Model Components collection, and it looks like this. Another example is Fence Assembly 8, which has a component span called Curved Fence Boards. This component looks like this. Now I'll show how to create a similar assembly from scratch, which will contain a component span. I have a partially built fence assembly called Iron Fence, which I'll draw out in a straight horizontal line. This fence has one profile member, the top rail. This is based on a profile called 2x4, which is oriented like this and has a center placement point. The one component in this assembly is called Post, and is based on the same profile. These are spaced at 4 feet max, and this component has its origin at the bottom center, which is why the top rail profile member needs -1 inch setbacks. Here are the objects I want to use as spans between posts. I'll make the entire thing a component and set its axes. By default, the origin is at the lower left corner of the component's bounding box, but I want the origin to line up with the center of the component. So I'll use inference points at these two midpoints and place the origin. The red and green directions are already correct, so I'll keep those and name the component Sunburst. In the Span tab, I'll add a new span, set its type to Component, name it Sunburst, and pick it from the model. I can see from the preview that I'll need some adjustments, and I'll apply changes to the fence to check the details. First, I'll add a vertical offset of 5 inches to get the components off the ground and properly aligned with the top rail. Later, I'll add another span below each component. In looking at where the span components meet their posts, I can see that the objects continue inside each post. Component spans don't have an auto trim option, and by default, a component's origin will be at the same location as the origin of the first support. Also by default, the red axis of the span component will point toward the second support. I can see this clearly in X-ray view, how the component origin is directly above the post origin, which is at the post center. In addition, scale to fit is enabled by default, which causes the component to be stretched along the red axis until it reaches the origin of the second support. Because the posts are 2 inch wide in this direction, I need to add 1 inch setbacks at both start and end. Now the components meet the sides of the posts. Because the span component origin is at its center, the components are centered correctly within the posts. If I want each component to be flush with the front of the posts, I could add a left-right offset. This value would be +1 inch. Also note that each component is a bit smaller than my original one. I can see this clearly when I place the original here to compare. This is because scale to fit is checked, which means the component will stretch or shrink along the component's red axis direction to accommodate the distance between posts. My post spacing is 4 feet max, and if I remove max, the components between most posts stretched a bit wider, but the one between the last two posts gets squashed pretty tightly. I could fix this by removing the last post. I'll put back the post and bring back max. For the span, I'll go back and uncheck scale to fit, and now the components are all at their original size. To finish the fence, I'll bring back scale to fit, then add another span, this time a profile member named bottom rail, which I'll pick from the model by opening the fence group. I'll use auto trim, change the vertical offset to 4 inches, and remove the 1 inch right offset from the previous component. And I'll set the material to match the other rails. Going back to the component span, the shear to fit option is relevant for assemblies along a slope. The sloped preview shows how the fence would look, and I'll draw one out along an angle. The top rail profile member can be easily fixed by checking global for up-down offset. The bottom rail span is already following the slope, but this isn't an option for span components. However, checking shear to fit will do the same thing. This option keeps the component's red axis along the assembly path. Now let's see what happens when posts aren't constrained to be vertical. I'll remove global from the top rail. For the component span, scale to fit is still needed, and removing shear to fit orients the spans correctly. The component's red axis follows the slope, as does the red axis of the posts. In the next video, I'll introduce sub-assembly spans.